He's got the face shield again. You know what that means.
It's time to talk safety.
I know we just did a safety video, but we only covered resin because resin is toxic. But you know, other types of 3D printing also have some safety concerns because, well, there are dangerous tools that have stabbing issues. There are clippers where you definitely don't cut off the tips of your fingers. There's things like blowtorches and fire that you have to be careful of so that you don't hurt yourself. But let's talk about FDM 3D printing and some of the safety involved in it. We've got a couple of categories here. We've got human safety. You, yes, you, the human. We've got the machine safety because, yes, machines also need to be safe, and pets or young kids. They're computer-controlled hot glue guns, which means what? They run stupid freaking hot. Hot ends. And if you don't know what this is, there's gonna be a card right here to that video all about the basics of hot ends in FDM 3D printers. These things get stupid hot when they're running. I am talking well over 200 degrees centigrade. And I don't know the number in Fahrenheit off the top of my head, so we'll throw it up here on the screen. But basically really freaking hot. These will give you second degree burns instantly and will likely cause you to cuss. It will happen. Guaranteed going to happen. Just be careful about it. Do not put a burn under cold water. That is how you get nerve damage. Learn from a pro, nerve damage sucks. Let's talk about it, right? How can I avoid getting burned by my 3D printer? One, buy a better 3D printer, right? Get a printer that isn't going to likely burn your house down, but two, is available for aftermarket options like hot end socks. This piece of silicone here is a great way to insulate all the heat in your hot end from the rest of your printer. It's pretty great, including your delicate little fingies. Even if you have an all-metal hot end, you can still have problems. Don't reach near the machine while it's running. Don't touch the freaking print bed. And print beds don't always run very hot, but like PLA, a print bed would be 65 degrees centigrade, which is roughly 140 degrees Fahrenheit. PETG is 85 degrees centigrade. And ABS and nylon run well over 100 degrees centigrade, which is enough to boil water. Don't touch your printer when it's hot. Machine safety. Don't turn off the machine if the hot end is hot. Let the machine cool down on its own. All machines will have a way to disable the heaters and let the machine cool down on its own. If you turn it off when the machine is hot, you are likely going to jam your hot end. By the way, if you want to learn how to unjam a hot end, get subscribed. We have a video all about that coming at you very soon. You want to keep the area as clean as possible. Just do as I say, not as I do, basically, right? We're running a business back here. If you are starting off, really, really clean. You cannot be too clean. Make sure that your rails are properly oiled, that your bearings are properly oiled. We use, actually it's in the background there, sewing machine oil. Sewing machine oil is great. It's a light oil. Unlike canola oil or olive oil, it doesn't get stale and rancid. It's great for getting past the wipers on a bearing and really keep those bearings lubricated over time. If you don't lubricate your bearings, they're going to dry out and they're going to have problems. Lubricate your darn bearings, and especially smooth rods on Prusa 3D printers. They will accumulate dirt, dust, grime, and other garbage. Wipe it off the rails, re-grease the rails, and you're done. It doesn't have to be complicated, but if you don't do those things, you're going to wear flat spots into your rods, which will create lots of excess noise and likely some artifacting inside of your prints, and we don't want that to happen. And don't abuse your machines. Machines have feelings too, I think. So if you do have a problem, do not just turn off the printer when it's running. Make sure to hit the reset button. Let it come back down to temperature on its own. There are some tools you need to be aware of when you're working with 3D printers, right? A lot of printers will come with these. These are like sharpened paint scrapers. It's basically what they are. Don't smack your machines with these. You'll break your machines. And also don't use, I have to say this because we've been through this. Don't use one of these to unclog your extruder. Like, don't get me wrong, tons of fun. But don't use one of these to unclog your extruder. You're going to melt your 3D printer. This is used for after printer work when you're cleaning up your parts, actually. We use this large propane torch often when we're cleaning off our 3D printed parts. By the way, video on that coming soon. Get subscribed. But if you also have young kids or older kids, and especially pets, you've got the scraps of plastic. And small pets, Victoria, love to play with little scraps of plastic. She does not eat the plastic. She's learned, but some pets may not know, and that can cause expenses you don't want to incur. So keep your space clean. A little shop vac, even a cheap old vacuum that you get up, you know, from maybe a thrift store or something, perfect for a plastic cleaning situation. And of course, if your local town or city allows it, make sure you recycle those plastic bits so that they don't end up in a landfill, or use a good biodegradable plastic like Polyterra. And it's funny because they don't sponsor us and we love their plastic. Keep the machine elevated so it's out of the reach of young or tiny prying hands. That way they don't touch a hot machine and end up having a temper tantrum. But more to think about is the tools. And not just the tool running the machine, but the tools you use to basically work after. These sharpened paint scrapers will stab your hand. Ask me how I learned. I have stabbed myself multiple times with these scrapers, and that's why we use cutting gloves. Now, the cheap cutting gloves on Amazon aren't necessarily the best for this. I've actually gone through those and into my hand. The nice chainmail ones, one, make you feel like you're working at medieval times, but two, will protect your hand considerably better from a sharp, stabby object like one of these. You've also got cutters. These are from Heiko. I do not like the blue ones that come with most cheap 3D printers. Get good cutters. Links in the description down below to all the things that we're talking about here today, so you can pick up tools like we use here at 3D Musketeers. These are awesome. They need to have a good point on them. You don't want to be able to see a lot of light or any light viably through them when you close it, and that it's nice and flush. Flush cutters are amazing, and they really, really help you do your job, but you can cut skin with them. So be careful. Even things like X-Acto knives. Yes, X-Acto knives. You should keep these covered at all time or in a place where it's out of reach of prying hands. Maybe in a block of styrofoam, although that dulls the blades out pretty quickly, but blades are incredibly cheap and you don't have to get branded ones to have good blades. But these hobby knives are incredibly useful for removing support material, cleaning up parts, and generally stabbing yourself in the finger. Be careful. Again, cutting gloves go a long way. And of course, always wear eye protection. Do you need the full face shield? Probably not. Do you want to wear the full face shield? Abso-freaking-lutely. One, tons of fun. Two, you can actually hear the plastic bouncing off of it. But even fake eyeglasses. Go get like cheap pairs of those blue light filtering glasses from Amazon. They will keep plastic particles out of the main portion of your face. And that's better than nothing. Right? Get all the safety you can afford and get more later on. Make sure to have a first aid kit handy because, again, it's gonna happen. On printers like Prusa's, you actually can basically completely get rid of these sharpened scrapers. Did you see how old this one is? It's a little rusty. You can basically get rid of these because of flex beds. These are Prusa build sheets. This one is a textured sheet. This one is a smooth sheet. And the nice thing about them is they are made of spring steel covered in PEI, polyether imide. That's actually a material that you can 3D print in, but not many printers can. If you want to learn about that, get subscribed. We have another video coming at you all about materials for both FDM and resin very, very soon. Yeah, these are flexible beds, so you don't need to use a scraper to push stuff off. You can just go pop and the parts just fly off into a low Earth orbit. And it works exactly the same for one of these smooth sheets. Ooh, that one's got all fingerprints. Let's use this side where you can flex it. And sometimes they make a cool noise. Flex steel sheets make 3D printing better. Machines like our Lulzbot TAS-6 don't have them, so we are still stuck using the sharpened paint scraper. We found that sometimes using a light rubber mallet, just kind of tap it to get underneath the part and then leaving it so it can slowly pry the part up with just basic spring steel force, is a great way to not end up stabbing yourself in the hand, but it does happen. Safety is important, people. And yes, you're probably not going to listen to me completely, and I understand that. So, you know, take everything I say with a grain of salt. But don't come complaining to me when you stab yourself in the hand. Because I don't complain to myself when I do it, because I forget my cutting gloves sometimes. Nobody's perfect. Anyways, we hope you learned something from it. Let us know in the comments below what you use in your everyday life to keep yourself from getting hurt while you are 3D printing. We'd love to have a conversation with you down there because, oh yeah, I'm the one that always replies to the comments. Anyways, stay safe out there. Don't forget to call your loved ones. And as always, keep making awesome. Have a good one.
Steel sheet noise!
Fire!